Hello, my students. I'm your biology teacher, Cikgu Govins. Our topic today is chapter 12, variations, and our subtopic is 12.1, type and factor of variations. Here are the learning standards. Learning standard number 1, describe the meaning of variations. Number 2, justify the necessity of variations for the survival of species. Number 3, describe the type of variations, continuous variation and discontinuous variation. Number 4, compare and contrast continuous and discontinuous variation. Number 5, relate causes of variations to type of variations. Genetic factor, which is crossing over, independent assortments of chromosomes, random fertilizations, and mutation. Number 2, environmental factor, temperature, light, and pH. And number 6, describe variation causes by interactions between genetic and environmental factor. Definitions of variations. Variation refer to the differences in characteristics found within the same populations or species. Density of variations, number 1, enable natural environments to continue selecting beneficial characteristics and remove the non-suitable ones. Number 2, ensure survival of the species when the environment changes. Number 3, allow crossbreedings among species to form new species. Type of variations. There are two types of variation, which is continuous variation and discontinuous variations. Okay, we look at continuous variation first. The differences in the characteristic is not distinct. Individuals show gradual differences from one extreme to the other extremes. So this means the differences are not obvious from one another. Okay, graph show a normal distribution curve. Okay, this is the normal distribution curve, also known as bell-shaped curve. Okay, have intermediate phenotype, which are characteristics found in between the two extremes. So this is the graph, this is the height range, and this is the number of people in the category of the range level here. Continuous variation is quantitative. It can be measured and graded from one extreme to other extremes. For example, body weight and height, we can measure it and grade it to form a normal distribution graph like this. The characteristics are influenced by environmental factor. For example, body weight and height can be influenced by diets and physical activity. Now we look at discontinuous variations. Discontinuous variations show distinct differences in characteristics. This means the differences in characteristics are obvious. And if data is obtained and plotted on the graph, a discrete distribution or a bar chart with separate bar are obtained. There are no intermediate characteristics. The characteristic is qualitative. It cannot be measured or graded. And this characteristic is determined by genetic factor and not influenced by environmental factor. Occurrence of discontinuous variation is due to genetic factor. Therefore, it can be inherited. A characteristic is determined by a single gene with two or three alleles, therefore the characteristic is easily seen. These are examples of discontinuous variations: ability to roll the tongues, fingerprint patterns, and type of earlobes. Comparisons between continuous and discontinuous variations. Okay, this means we have to look the similarity and differences. So the similarity is show differences in characteristics among individuals of the same species. And differences for continuous variation, no obvious differences in characteristics, whereas discontinuous variation, obvious and distinct differences in characteristics. Differences number 2, presence of intermediate characteristics for continuous variation, whereas in discontinuous variations, no intermediate characteristics. Differences number 3, for continuous variation, graph with normal distributions, whereas for discontinuous variations, graph with discrete bar. Next, for continuous variation, characteristic is controlled by many genes, whereas for discontinuous variations, characteristic is controlled by one single gene. Next, for continuous variation, influenced by environmental factor, whereas this continuous variations The characteristic is not influenced by environmental factor. The last differences for continuous variation can be measured, or we call it quantitative. For this continuous variations cannot be measured, or we call it qualitative. Causes of variations. The characteristics of continuous variations are influenced by environmental factor, whereas characteristics of discontinuous variations are influenced by genetic factor. Okay, we look at environmental factor. Environmental factor that cause variation include factors such as temperature, light, and pH, whereas genetic factor, crossing over, independent assortments of chromosome, random fertilizations, and mutations. Okay, we look at genetic factor. Factor number one is crossing over. Crossing over occurs between non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosome during prophase 1 of meiosis. So this diagram shows a pair of homologous chromosomes. This diagram shows crossing over occurs at chiasma. So exchange of non-sister chromatid segments occur here. And then this is a new combination of genes. Sister chromatid that separate during anaphase 2 of meiosis form gamete with different genetic material at the end of meiosis. Factor number 2, independent assortments of chromosomes. During metaphase 1 of meiosis, a homologous chromosome pair, okay, this is homologous pair, one maternal chromosome and one is paternal chromosomes, is arranged randomly on the equatorial planes of a cell. Two probability on the arrangements of homologous chromosome on the equatorial planes for each diploid cells. So at the end of meiosis, different gamete will be produced with different combinations of paternal and maternal chromosome, which result in the genetic content of each gamete to be different from others. Factor number 3, random fertilizations. Fertilization between sperm and secondary oocyte is random. So genetic recombination which occur during crossing over and random arrangements of homologous chromosome in meiosis produce gamete with different genetic content from their parents. Therefore, a diploid zygote which is produced after fertilization will have new genetic combinations. The last factor, mutations. Mutation is a permanent change which occurs spontaneously on gamete or chromosomes. Mutations create new genotype. If mutations occur in the gametes, the characteristics determined by mutated genetic material can be inherited. But if the mutations occur in the somatic cell, they can cause variations, but the characteristics cannot be inherited by the next generation. We will learn more about mutations in next subtopics 12.3. Okay, this is the diagram show the mutations, how it occur. Now we look at environmental factor. There are three factors, soil pH, temperature, and light. Hydrangea plants produce blue flower in acidic soils. Okay, this one. And pink flower in alkaline soils. Temperature. Siamese cat inherited the genes which produce dark pigments enzyme for fur color. This enzyme only functions at temperature less than body temperature. Part of body with lower temperature are ear, face, tail, and paw. Therefore, these body parts are dark in color. So look at these diagrams. This Siamese cat. Light. Sunlight can alter skin color. People who under the sun for a long period of time will have tan skins. For example, a construction worker. Ultraviolet ray in sunlight can destroy melanin pigments of exposed skins. Therefore, more melanin pigment will be produced, which cause the skin to be darker. Okay, this is the diagrams. Interaction between genetic and environmental factor. Environmental factor can interact with genetic factor to cause variation, in which the environmental factor determine the phenotypes. Characteristics inherited from parents, such as height, intelligence, and skin color, are greatly influenced by environmental factors. An example which supports the effects of environmental factor on genetic factor can be observed in identical twins. So look at these diagrams. Number one, J and K are identical twins. Both have similar genotype for obesity, since they originate from the same embryo. Number two, J and K were separated since childhood. J like low fat diets and enjoy physical activity, whereas K like high fat diets and does not like physical activity. After 18 years, K is obese, whereas J has an ideal body weight. So the conclusion is, differences in eating habit and environment while growing up produce different phenotypes. Formative practice 12.1. Here are the questions. Question number 1. How can variation increase the survival of species? The answer is, an organism in a population that have variation possesses characteristics which is adaptable to the environment compared to other organisms within the same population which do not have the variations. Question number 2. Determine the following variations: intelligence, presence of dimples, type of hair, height, and type of earlobes. The answer is, characteristics of intelligence is continuous variation because intelligence can be measured. How to measure it? Through example is through the IQ examinations. Presence of dimples is discontinuous variation because presence of dimples show distinct differences in characteristics. Type of hair is discontinuous. Height is continuous because height can be measured. Type of earlobe is discontinuous. Example are attached earlobe or free earlobes. Question number 3. State 2 causes of variations. The answer is genetic factor and environmental factor. Number 4. Variation occur because of sexual reproductions. Explain the above statements. The answer is, sexual reproduction involves fertilization between male gametes and female gametes. So crossing over occur between non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosome during 4-phase 1 of meiosis produce new combinations of genes. During metaphase 1 of meiosis, a homologous chromosome pair is arranged randomly on the equatorial planes of the cell. Fertilization between sperm and secondary oocyte is random. Therefore, a diploid zygote, which is produced after fertilization, will have a new genetic combination. That's all for today. Thank you and see you in next lesson. Bye-bye.